welcome everyone on our live stream. We're just getting the stage set up for our first act today on the Palmer Festival Day. Thank you everyone for joining us. We're running just a few minutes late here, so it's just give us a few minutes to get the stage set up. While we're doing that, there is a link on your screen to a GoFundMe page. We are collecting money for some maintenance on our building. We have one of the bell towers needs some maintenance done, and into this weekend, the roofers are there getting that taken care of. The building, the operation, the maintenance of the building is our largest expense for keeping this accordion museum open, and so we really need your support to help continue to bring events like what we're bringing to you this weekend. So we encourage you to check out that GoFundMe page and make a donation if you can, because that really helps us keep the operation moving. We're all supported by donations, and we could really use your help in continuing to produce events like you're seeing this weekend. If you missed some of the live streams from yesterday, they were spectacular, and so they'll be up on the YouTube channel for a long time, so check those out and share those with your friends. If you're impressed, you certainly will be impressed by some of those presentations. Share those with your friends. We appreciate you sharing that and helping us spread the word about what we're doing here at A World of Accordions. Here for just a little bit while we finish getting the stage set up, and we're going to have Mike Middleton on in probably about 10 minutes. So stay with us, and we'll be back shortly. Thank you. Thank you. watching by live stream, thank you for joining us. We're going to get our performance started here in just a moment. You're going to turn the aux, individual aux up. They go about straight up. Okay. So if everyone could take their seats, we're going to get started here in just a little bit. And a reminder to everyone, please silence your cell phones. So don't be the person that forgets. So as an example, I'm going to silence my cell phone. There, mine's silenced, so I'm not going to be that person. Thank you for helping with that. Please check out for those watching by the live stream, I'll remind you again, there's a GoFundMe link in the description of the video. We appreciate your support, so please check that out. I think we're ready to go. I'm going to turn it over to Dr. Helmy Harrington for the introduction of Mike Middleton.
Welcome to another wonderful day of music making and happy moments. It's an extraordinary event to have such great artists on stage and the beautiful music that is presented as a result. I'm so happy to be able to announce Mike Middleton. He was a student of mine when he was a teenager, and then both of us went different directions, and he excelled in medicine and is now new chief of staff,
nuclear medicine
at Scott & White, and as a result, too, continued to keep his musical experiences current and lively. So the Accordion Stars magazine announced him as a favorite virtuoso player in the whole United States. Is that wonderful? I think that's great. And that was in the same magazine that I got to be Woman of the Year. That's not so bad either. Mike has absolutely fabulous credentials. I hope you look him up sometime on the web, because he's not only extraordinary as a human being, but also an extraordinarily nice human being. So here we are, Mike.
Thank you, Helmy. It's always an honor to be here, and it's a special honor to be back with my mentor, Dr. Helmy Harrington, who I've known for too many years now, right? I was just a little pre-high school student when we started, right? Anyway, I am delighted this year to be back, and I'm going to do something special. Last year I did a tribute to one of my heroes, who was Dick Contino, and this year I'm going to still play some of his music, tell some more stories, but I'm also going to try to tie it into the Palmer Hughes books. Today is the Palmer Fest, and I thought it'd be appropriate to play some of the songs from the Palmer Hughes series, and we'll do that. But first, let me remind you about Dick Contino. Probably more than any other accordionist, he increased the number of accordion players in the United States dramatically. And it was because he was just such an exceptional teenage player. When he was 19, let me start back up a little bit. His dad was from Italy and wanted him to play the accordion. So he started playing the accordion at an early age. And he even took lessons from several people, but from Guido Germano, who we've all talked about in prior things. And Guido was famous in his own right for playing on the vaudeville circuit. So he was kind of a hero of Dick Contino's. So I thought it'd be appropriate to start off with this song that we also heard yesterday, but this is kind of my version of it, the way Dick Contino would play it, and it's called The 12th Street Rag. And it's a perfect song to start off with because it kind of represents that vaudeville era. Thank you. So how did Dick Contino reach fame so quickly? Well, back then, these were the radio days, okay? The late 40s. It was particularly, I think it was in 1947, that they had these contests, and Dick Contino entered this contest. He was from Fresno, California, and the Horace Height was a very famous band conductor at the day, and he was having a contest. It's kind of like what you see today with like Singing with the Stars or one of those things where people from all over the country would enter. But Dick Contino entered, and he had everything going for him. He was technically very good. He was just a really good-looking guy, so the girls loved him, okay? And then he just had that thing that performers that attract audiences have. But he was kind of nervous during some of his contests. He ultimately won first place after competing over like several months every week playing for a contest. This was all on radio. But in the radio audience were lots of teenage girls. And Dick was nervous, particularly towards the end. And Horace Height told him, he says, "There's no need for you to be nervous, Dick, because all you have to do is two things. One is smile at the girls, and two is to shake those bellows." And so Dick took that to heart, especially on this song, that made this song famous and made the accordion, in fact, famous. It's called Lady of Spain, one of my favorites. Thank you.
everybody, especially teenagers between the ages of 11, maybe up to their 20s, we're starting to learn about this teenager named Dick Contino. Now remember, this was before rock and roll, and it was before TV. So this was all radio. And so Dick Contino probably did more for the sales of the accordion than any one person. In the 1950s, the accordion manufacturers in Italy were selling hundreds, of, probably thousands of accordions, and most of them were going to the United States. So he just influenced a lot of people. One of the most important people to Dick was his father. His father was a strong influence for him. He was a butcher, and his father really wanted him to learn the accordion in the first place. As I read his biography, Dick wasn't that interested when he first started playing, but he found out that people liked the way he looked and the way he played, and so he started taking the accordion as almost part of his own persona, and it was a way that he could express himself. His dad wanted him to learn quite a few Italian songs, and this is probably one he learned, and it's one that made its way into the Palmer Hughes books. It's a famous Italian song, and I'll just show you. Those of us who play the accordion have taken lessons with the Palmer method. There's different books like this, and this one is called Come Back to Sorrento. Thank you. Now, after Dick went and won some of those contests, he was being asked to play constantly for TV shows and all kind of dance events and things like that, and he was very highly paid. So he was just like any teenager that all of a sudden hits a lot of money. He was just flabbergasted, and he was dating, you know, women from Hollywood, and just beyond his wildest dreams, his family couldn't believe it. And he was doing all kind of stuff. And if you watch some of these old YouTube videos of Dick Contino, he's sitting there playing, and there's just these women hanging all over him and rubbing his shoulders while he plays. It was every guy's dream at the time. So he was just an amazing guy. The next song I wanted to play for you, he realized that he had to kind of expand his genre of music. And while he played all kinds of stuff, especially South American, Italian, European songs, he was getting asked all the time to play polkas. The accordion is still and always has been known for playing polkas. And Dick liked certain polkas. This is one of his favorites. It happens to be one of my favorite, and it's also in the Palmer Hugh series. This one happens to be in G. And when I heard Dick play this on a recording, he does it pretty quickly, so I'm trying to mimic what he does. And I think you'll enjoy it. It's called the clarinet polka. And I've heard it's like the only polka that has a doctoral thesis written about it as the perfect polka, all the elements of a polka. And anyway, it goes like this. Thank you. Now, later this afternoon, I'll have a treat for you because in the Palmer Hughes book, it actually has two parts. It has the first part and the second part, and I've always wanted to kind of play that. I played it with other accordions, but when I met my tuba player who you linked this afternoon, we decided that we do it as an accordion and tuba duet of the clarinet polka, so you'll get to hear how that sounds. Another song that Dick played, especially in South American music, and Latin American music, is a song straight out of Book 7, and I'll play a version of it. And you can't do an accordion concert without at least playing some sort of tango. Well, this is a tango that Dick Contino liked. It's one you've all heard about, and it's the one you see as someone walking around with a rose in their mouth, okay? So if anybody wants to do that, welcome to it. And Dick liked to embellish his songs. I hope you get that impression. So he loved glissandos, he loved tremolos, so I'll try to do some of that. Thank you. So those were fun songs to play when I was young. And I thought it'd be fun to play those for this concert, just to show some of the types of songs that they have in the Palmer Hughes method. This next song is more related to Dick Contino's history, but it's also in one of the Palmer Hughes books. It's in a recital book. I think it's in book 3. I'm playing a little bit different variation. Mine is closely more related to the way Dick Contino did it, but I wanted to illustrate a point about him. He was a very patriotic guy. He was drafted into the Korean War, and he did serve. One of my favorite stories in his biography is he was kind of reluctant to go, and they didn't want him to bring his accordion for obvious reasons, which was too bad because he knew he could serve his country by playing the accordion somehow. Well, he gets drafted. They put him in the infantry, so he had to learn how to shoot a rifle. He arrives in Korea, and one of the first days he's there, he's at one of these party areas where all the soldiers are. And there's this little band kind of huddled in the back of the room. And the guy's sitting there. It looks like he's reading a letter from a girlfriend or something. And there's an accordion sitting right next to the guy's feet. And so Dick Contino, you know, he's all shaved and everything. He comes up to the guy and says, "Hey, can I play your accordion for the troops?" And the guy looks up, takes off his hat, and says, who do you think you are, Dick Contino?" So Dick takes off his hat and says, "Matter of fact, I am Dick Contino." And the guy, like, fell off his chair. So Dick picks it up and starts playing all kind of stuff. And from then on, he was a hero because all the soldiers kind of got around him and started watching. They knew who he was. Some of the leaders in the staff didn't really know much about Dick Contino, but the younger soldiers knew who Dick Contino was. Anyway, his CO eventually recognized that this guy needs to be out entertaining the troops. So he was put in charge of an entertainment unit, and that's how he served his country. He went around to different areas within Korea and played. After he got back, he found that he wasn't quite as popular as he was when he left. And the reason for that is because times had changed a little bit. It was a few years later, and rock and roll had come, and there was a young entertainment guy named Elvis Presley, who was the new Dick Contino, and now there were lines out the door just to see this Elvis Presley guy. So Dick found it a little bit more difficult to find work right after that, but he managed to get a lot of bookings. One of them was on the Ed Sullivan Show, and he developed a strong relationship with Ed Sullivan, and I'll tell you about that in a minute. But Dick was always very patriotic, and he tried to play patriotic songs in his music. This is one of his favorites. It's called The Battle Hymn of the Republic.
Thank you.
President of the Republic.
All the time that Dick was performing all over the United States, he was constantly being asked to do certain standards on the accordion. And one of them was this one. This is an old favorite of mine that some of you may have played before. It's called Dizzy Fingers. It was written by Zez Confrey for the piano, and it was converted into an accordion piece, but it became really probably more popular on the accordion. And it moves along very quickly. I can see why Dick Contino really liked this one. It's a lot of fun to play. Fingers. Now, I actually knew some people who had seen Dick play many times because one of my friends in medical school, mother, was sort of a distant cousin of Dick Contino, and every time he would come to some of their family reunions, her and her friend, her cousins, all these girls would gather around and say, "Oh, Mr. Contino, can you play that song called Flight of the Bumblebee?" And Dick would say, "Oh, okay, here we go." This is also in the Palmer Hughes method. It happens to be in the last book, like one of the last songs, so it's fairly difficult, but it moves along quickly, and you can see why Dick Contino would like it. He likes songs with lots of flair. So here we go, and it's by Rimsky-Korsakov called Flight of the Bumblebee. Sometimes that bumblebee gets away from me a little bit. But still, it's a fun song to play if you ever want to learn it. Dick was playing for all kinds of TV shows, and I talked about his relationship with Ed Sullivan.
Ed Sullivan was kind of before my time, but I did see a couple of the reruns, and you can watch YouTube videos of the Ed Sullivan Show. Dick Contino has the world record for being on the Ed Sullivan Show, I believe, 47 times, which is just phenomenal. And they kind of grew up together. In fact, Dick led a delegation with Ed Sullivan when Nixon opened up the relationship with China and with Russia. So Dick kind of helped lead some of the music for that. But he plays songs that were standards from TV. And this is what a recurrent theme about Dick Contino is, he would play what the people wanted to hear. And they usually saw things on TV shows or on movies that were very popular, and they'd want to hear these songs. So this is a typical one. It's one of my favorites that Dick Contino played. It's called Moon River. Thank you. That, of course, was Moon River by one of my favorite composers, Henry Mancini. All right. Another thing that Dick would do is he got asked to play for all these large festivals, especially in Chicago and California. But one of the biggest ones that he played for routinely was called Festa. And it was in Chicago. And there's a, one of his biographies is by a guy named Bob Bove, who helped kind of establish the Festa. And Dick would play all kind of Italian songs, but some other stuff. He liked to play a boogie that he kind of wrote. And I wanted to pick this song because it's one of the only songs that I know that he actually kind of arranged and wrote. It's called the Contino Boogie. That was the Contino Boogie. And it reminds me to say something about that. His last 20 years or 30 years playing, and I forgot to mention, Dick Contino played from the age of 19 in public all the way until his mid-80s. And the other thing is he never sat down. And I have tremendous respect for that because it's hard playing the way he plays and with the energy level he did. But he always stood up. And I have two things in common with Dick. I'm not as good a player, but I do play the accordion. And the other thing is I have a son that plays drums with me. And Dick Contino's son played drums with him through these tours around the United States and even into Las Vegas when they played. So I know he's very proud of his son, and I think his son is probably watching. And his other musical partner was Corky Bennett. Okay, and Corky Bennett helped arrange a lot of his stuff with Dick and provided the musical backing. So that trio played for many years, and they were very popular, especially in Las Vegas and at the Festa shows. Okay. Another song that Dick Contino liked was El Cumbinchero. And again, I mentioned that he liked to play stuff that was popular on TV. This is from the I Love Lucy show. It's a song that I like to play because it reminds me of that show. And, of course, the reason I learned it in the first place is because my beautiful wife, who's in the back, told me, hey, I want you to learn how to play that song. It's called El Cumbinchero. ¶¶ That was El Campuchero. And I call that part of the accordion diet right there. That'll burn some calories. All right. Well, I'm coming to the end of my time here. I started a little late, but I hope you'll bear with me on this next song because I wanted to dedicate this song to the people of Ukraine. It's a terrible time in the world, and we all know what's going on with the war in Ukraine. And the very last book of the Palmer Hughes series is, book 10. And the very last song in the very last book is called, a song called Variations on a Ukrainian Theme. And it's a song that I've played all my life, and I've loved it. It's one of my most requested songs, so I thought it'd be a good time to play this. It's also known as the Minka. And you actually heard a variation of that song yesterday. But this is a variation more closely to what resembles the Palmer Hughes series. And I've added a few of my own types of variations and my own embellishments, but it's a lot of fun to play. I started off very slow, and then I worked my way up to speed. I hope you like it. Feel free to clap along, by the way. Thank you. Thank you. So I will be back in the afternoon with my band. I call it Mike and the Middletones, and we'll play some similar songs, but mainly polkas, waltzes, and fun stuff to play with. And I will have my son on drums and my good friend Clayton Katz, who is over here, on tuba. So we'll see you at 1 o'clock. Thank you.
Set up for the next act now. For those of you joining us on the live stream, okay, we'll try it this way. So for those of you that are joining us on the live stream, we have a link put up on this on the screen for our GoFundMe page. You'll also see there's a band there from Jamar Roofing. They've been working on the roof of one of our bell towers this past
week. Thank you.
We need some support to help continue our operation here. All of our support is through contributions from people that enjoy the productions that we put on. So we encourage you to support the work we're doing here. If you'd like to see this continue, please go to the GoFundMe link and support us in any way that you can. And just a note, Mike talked about the times of Dick Contino. A lot of funding for events like this in the past, it was funded by the accordion manufacturers. And now that just the way the industry is and the way the music industry is going, that doesn't quite work the same way. So events like this are funded through contributions from people that like to see it on YouTube. And they're tax deductible. That's a great point. Thank you, Jane, our secretary from the board, reminded me they are tax deductible donations. And we will send you a letter, donations, on the GoFundMe page. So thank you for your support on that. Just a technical note. For each of our presentations today, we are going to do a separate live stream. So at the end, we're going to stop the live stream, and then we're going to restart it again. So if you want to catch the next one, just give us about 5 or 10 minutes to reset the stage. When we restart the live stream, you're going to have to find the link again. There's a live now button, so just watch for that. If you want to get notifications, there's a bell icon you can click on, and then you'll be notified when we go live. So check those out. And just search around on our YouTube channel. There'll be a live now button. That's what you want to find to see us when we're going live. So we're going to stop the stream, and we'll be started here in just a few minutes with our next performer. Thank you.